And welcome back to my channel, or welcome to new members of our community. My name is Yasa, and I'm a violinist, and I moved to United States, Florida from St. Petersburg, Russia almost 10 years ago all by myself. And in this pandemic time, I had so much free time like all of us, and I decided to share with you my journey, my struggles, and my joys on this journey of moving countries and adjusting to new lifestyle, and sharing with you my musical advice too, and how to build a life of a musician. I dressed up very fancily today for you guys, my opera scarf, as I call it. And anyways, I wanted to talk today about traditions in Russia that are maybe a bit superstitious. So superstition believes in Russia that my friends find funny here. So maybe it will be something funny for you too. My friend always comments and always steps on my feet and then saying that, "Oh, you won't be lucky anymore." It's his joke. But to tell you the truth, in Russia, we believe that if someone steps on your foot, you have to reciprocate. You have to step on their feet too. It's not about luck, okay? It's about being friends. So if someone steps on your foot and you're not gonna step back, you guys probably not gonna be friends. And since I grew up with that belief, I always try to, step back, and he just runs away. So I guess we at some point not gonna be friends, which will be so sad. So that is one of the beliefs. Another one that we share with Americans, I think black cats, right? We always mindful of black cats in Russia. If a black cat crosses your path, it means something unlucky gonna happen. And I think we believe the same here in United States. And that is so sad for the poor little black cats, because what did they do wrong, you know, not to deserve our love? We are pretty superstitious. In Russia, we have a lot of beliefs. For example, for New Year, we give each other, we celebrate this tradition of Chinese zodiac signs and yearly signs. So every year has a special animal spirit, spirit animal, I guess, that brings luck to you this specific year. So I'm a snake. I was born in the year of snake. So I been giving different keychains and little statues of snake just to bring me luck. And the year of snake that repeats every 12 years, so cycle. It's supposed to be my lucky year, and we do believe in this in Russia. And every year we celebrate a new spirit animal, and we have a little figurine of that animal on our table, and we feed him too. We feed him, we please him to allow us to have luck in, and prosperity in the new year. And we give it each other keychains, candles with the figurine of that spirit animal of that specific year. I need to find out what year is coming. I wonder what is it. Then we also believe in, this is not for everyone, but I know some of my friends in Russia believe in color coordination. For example, red color supposed to bring you health and luck. So if you wear red, and if you put some red material or red paper in your wallet, you're supposed to be rich. So this is something that my mom believes in. For example, she tries to wear red and encourages me to do the same. Well, I just like red. I think it's a good color and it attracts brightness and eyeballs on you. So that's good. It's always good. Okay, one more thing that my friend always laughs about, and of course he does it on purpose. He always whistles indoors. In Russia, we believe if you whistle indoors, you're never gonna have money. You're never gonna have money. So this goes directly with money. And of course, he whistles all the time, and he's not a millionaire yet, but we'll see, maybe one day. Okay, that one is interesting. I don't know if we have that in America, but my dad follows that. Whenever you see a penny on the street in Russia, it's another currency, right? But still a little coin on the street, you're not supposed to just pass by. You're supposed to pick it up and put it in your wallet. And I know right now in pandemic, it sounds like a horrible thing to do. You know, it's dirty and I can't imagine doing that. But my dad does it religiously. He believes if he just walks by money, they're gonna pass him by. So you have to be respectful of the gifts that are sent to you. And if it's a small coin on the street and you see it, you're supposed to pick it up, be grateful and put it in your wallet, and prosperity will follow it. A little superstition for you from musician's point of view. So it's very common for us to have our music fall on the floor, right? It's happening pretty often. It happens to me many times. So whenever music falls on the floor in Russia, at least, you're supposed to sit down, you're supposed to sit on the music. It's also something about luck and about good performance. So if you're not gonna do that, you probably not gonna have successful performance. So music falls, you're supposed to sit, even if it's on the floor. I know it sounds funny, but we musicians and artists are very superstitious. And before you go on stage, you wish in United States and in Russia, this very common phrase, break a leg. So you wish something opposite of what actually you want to happen. So I guess it goes to believe, goes to say that minimize the importance of that event. So if you don't expect much, it's gonna be great. I don't know why is that so, but we wish to break a leg, and what we really mean is to have a great performance. In Russia, we have the same. We wish, we say ni puha ni pera, which means don't have any peace or any comfort, basically. So we also wish bad thing for you to happen, but actually, it means have a great time, have a great performance. What are your superstitious beliefs, and what are the traditions that you find interesting and superstitious in your country, and you grew up with it, not even knowing why is it so, why is that tradition in place, but it's been happening and you just kind of follow along. Have a great day, everyone. Please like and subscribe, and I'll see you soon. Ask me what you would like me to talk about in the next videos, and have a great day. Happy pandemic, everyone. Bye. Пока.